does Lon McCarron prepare for this wonderful event, the circus that is known as this final table of the main event?
You know, it's just a matter of having some perspective on what's happening, bringing that perspective to the viewers on how big an event this is for these final nine players, for their family, for their friends, for everyone who's going to be at the Penn and Teller Theater. And it just seems to get better every year. We get a little more history. You know, every year, of course, is different, and so we have more empirical evidence to draw upon and more things to talk about. The team of myself, Norman Chad, Antonio S. Van Diaria, I think just get better working together each year. As far as preparation, you know, we've been following these players throughout the main event, throughout the, even though it was only, you know, 7 days for them, it's been several months for us in preparation of the shows, in preparation of each week. And so we've hopefully come to know them well, relayed a lot of that information to the audience. And right now it's just a matter of seeing what they've been up to in the last 4 months, seeing where they've been playing, how they're feeling. And, you know, they're connecting well with each other. So it's just, you know, fleshing it out, bringing the story together, and hopefully, you know, presenting the exciting action as accurately as possible.
Hey, I got to ask you, in 03, when everyone's saying Farhad would come back and beat the kid, just too experienced. I remember Dan Harrington saying that. Did you have a sense then of what was about to happen? I mean, this epic rise of this game that we all love right into the mainstream.
Not at all, honestly. And to be truthful, you know, my eyes were so wide open the whole time because that was my first venture to a live final table. I had done the final table the year before for ESPN with Gabe Kaplan when Robert Varconi won. And as a sideline, I don't think Robert gets enough credit for bringing more people into the 03 World Series. I mean, his performance as an amateur and, you know, what he did to all those pros, I think deserves a lot of credit for bringing more people into the 03 event, making it as big as it was. But that being said, I wasn't there at the event live. Just the way it fell out. So coming into 03, I was still just kind of slack-jawed and wide-eyed at what was going on, trying to understand the dynamics, trying to understand the people. You know, I knew Moneymaker was a newcomer, but I didn't know much about Farhad at the time. So no, as we produced the shows, I certainly knew, you know, in retrospect, what was going on and how big it was going to be. And we had that luxury because we were voicing it later on.
Yeah, you knew you had something good while it was being edited and put together. You just had a feeling that it was just happening, that this was, hey, this is good.
Well, we knew, I mean, we knew how unique it was to have this guy come in and, you know, spend $39 and then win $2.5 million. And we knew that the other players he was taking out were big players. And but what we didn't know is the fallout from his victory, what was going to happen. And it was just quirky. You know, I ran into a CBS producer that I had worked with before who was only there because his name was Moneymaker. And, you know, they intended to cover him for a couple of days and then go away. But they, you know, they never went away because neither did Chris. So the fallout was totally unexpected. And it's been a magic ride since.
Norman Chad, have you guys always, first of all, what kind of guy is he? Is the guy we see on TV and listen to, is that really Norman Chad? Is he really that guy? And have you always had good chemistry with him? Because you guys have excellent chemistry.
Yeah, what you see with Norman is pretty much what you get. It's even a little more extrovert than he is in real life. He'd rather avoid crowds. He gets along with animals better than people, he would tell you.
Really?
He'd rather just not, you know, get out there and be in the big party. He's fine one-on-one. He's one of the smartest people I know. Journalistically, has so much integrity, and it's a joy to be around him. I think he's the backbone of our shows on the direction we take, the right choices we make journalistically. And he's always about telling the truth, and that's, you know, his newspaper background, and goes hand-in-hand with what I'm looking to do, too. And I was a fan of his actually before we worked together, before we met. He wrote a syndicated column, still does, weekly. And it was an NFL picks column back in 02 when I was reading him in my San Jose, California newspaper, and would just laugh every Friday morning would come out. So I was a big fan of his sense of humor, his cynicism, his biting sarcasm. And so I was thrilled to learn that we were going to be working together, and I was in awe of him, and I learned so much from him about presentation of event and certainly about poker. And so we just seemed to click. You know, he's got his role, I got my role. We have different senses of humor, but still they're parallel. And whatever we were doing, you know, what I try to do with any partner is to make them comfortable, to make them look good, to have fun with it, but on top of all, is get it right and have integrity. And so all of our goals really matched each other's, and it was just one of those things. It fell together and it felt right.